the survivors. This might take a while.
To me, Flames!
There'll be survivors inside.
You've caused quite the commotion. But then I would expect no less from you, Muthos.
You again. I don't believe we've been introduced. You were in my family's crypt. And now you're here. With an army of Akashic thralls.
Manners, Lord Rosfield? They are men, like you and me. Albeit ones unburdened by the wills that drive our kind to madness. They are pure. They are divine.
What?
And they are all that remains in this once raucous city.
You'll pay for what you've done.
As you wish. I confess, I have been very much looking forward to this. Pardon me, this indulgence, Your Majesty. The vessel shall not be spoiled. I am the late man of House Harvard, and you will yield. Or not.
As long as you don't hold back.
Nice try.
Forgive me if my performance seems uninspired. It is just that I expected so much more from our chosen one.
What now?
A gift from my liege lords, are I? Gungnir.
Watch closely, Muthos.
Yes! Yes!
Hey! Ha! you're not agreeing.
Actually, I wouldn't. Too slow.
The vessel is strong. My liege.
Clive!
You're all right.
As are you, I see.
We are, yes.
I'm sorry, but we couldn't save them.
It was over before we arrived.
Well, you did what you could. I fear we were all too late.
Mythos?
It's the king.
Warden of Ash and King of Walud.
Get back.
Expected more of the boy who bested my lord commander. Yet I see why my master covets you so.
Muthos.
But Muthos is everything. The lord's vessel. Your purpose.
Purpose? To surrender my mind and body to that thing. No, Your Majesty. My purpose is my own. I made a promise to my friends, to my people. And nothing is going to stand in my way.
You would allow this delusion of free will to bar your path to greatness? Truly, your volition is a cancer. One that must be excised.
Joshua!
beyond reckoning, and they use it as a crutch. Such a waste.
Must recover on its own. I'm afraid the rest is up to him. This place is remarkable. Outfitting it must have been no small feat. But why go to such trouble?
That beauty's belly's filled with wonders the world ain't ready for. If the guilds caught wind of what we're up to, they'd all want a piece. All right.
And how is he? Do not blame yourself. He was barely breathing when you brought him here. We would have lost him if it were not for you.
No. Barnabas may have severed nigh every sinew in my brother's body. But he made certain the wounds were not fatal.
Nigh every sinew?
Allow me, your lordship. Don't know what I was thinking, putting you to the trouble like that.
'Tis no trouble carrying comestibles to my ailing nephew.
I know, but you've already done so much for us. Pouring your gill into the hideway and now the ship. I don't want to take the piss.
You risked your life. And for what? Some girl you hardly know. Why'd you do it? You got mad or something?
I wouldn't go that far.
Clive!
You're awake.
My boy.
What I want to do is help. And the world won't save itself. It was Sid. Your father, who taught me that.
Sounds like him.
Don't you dare do that again.
What of the Royalists?
Fucked off, the lot of them. Along with the galleon. With the king on board, no doubt. The Iron Hair, I wouldn't sail without him. Clive. Jill didn't come back.
What do you mean?
She kept the king busy while the others dragged you out.
It's all right, Mid. Jill is fine.
The ether of her icon endures. And as long as it does, we can be certain she is alive.
We must pursue the Black Galleon. Jill will be with the king, I'm sure of it.
Well, good luck catching him, because my ship's going nowhere. It's the Mithril engine. She's got a kick like a wild chocobo and a mind to tear the hull in half.
But do you have an idea?
Well, of course I do. My dad'll have seen this coming a league off. If I had his old writings...
If you had his old writings, you'd be sitting under a fuckload of rubble. The ones Otto didn't save anyway. I suppose you might still have a few pages in his stores.
We'll have to hope it's enough. Do what you can to ready the ship. I'll speak with Otto.
In your condition? You really are mad.
Perhaps. But the world really won't save itself. right. Gav said that Otto might know something.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to DelCast Gaming. This is part three. I was fighting the Odin guy, and he, like, wrecked me after one hit, so I couldn't fight back or anything. It's just part of the story, I guess. And so, that's where I was at on story mode. So I'm going to continue with the story, maybe. Or if there's any hunts, I should do the hunts first. See if there's any new hunts. There are. Okay, so I'm gonna do those hunts. The reason why I would like to get these hunts done is so I can be strong.
I'm a potato.
The airman again. Okay. Oh wait, no, I got the airman already. Oh, this is the one. The dread comet. And the man in black. So those two hunts I'm gonna have to do or continue the story. I am gonna go ahead and see if there's any other side quests that I can do. Usually these side quests, you can talk, or not talk, you can go up to your room and there's a little booklet thing that you gotta look through. And a lot of times they'll give you the next see if I need anything from around. Probably do, because I remember almost dying a couple times, so.
Let me tell you a story.
Alright.
Them rumors went legs were spreading. Might be they weren't just tales plucked out of thin air. See, there was a time when I wasn't particular about myself still too, so long as they paid me the right price. Some women must have done things after flesh, but not me. I will always want for gold. To satisfy that lust, I sought opposing armies, stabbed my every client in the back, made myself the most dated woman in the twins. But then one day I met a man who made me a different kind of offer. Said he'd give me access to a worldwide community of like-minded individuals in constant need of stable sunbeams. On the condition I sold to him and his alone.
Was that the first time you met Sid?
Aye. And I fell right into his damn trap. He was true to his word, so I ended up being true to mine. And I soon started making the best profits I've seen since taking up the trade. And all without aiding or abetting any outcomes. Sepsid himself, that is. Told me about his plan to topple the mother crystals, you know. Said that with them gone, the realm would offer all manner of things. An opportunity for the likes of me to mingle.
I found yourself the richest jam in the twins.
And that's when he had me. I emptied my stores out there and moved into the Hardaway proper. And the rest, as they say, is ancient modern history. A dozen years on, and I'm still not the richest, Dan. Not for lack of trying, mind. But I can say that I have never been happier. You've all shown me there are some things more precious than gold.
That there are.
So don't go missing it all up, or you'll have me to answer to.
Alright, well. Learn a little bit more about her, but I really just want to see if she has anything to purchase. Let's go ahead and purchase that. Yep, and equip it. Wind belt. Oh, another powerful one now. It does bring me down some. Not too much, though. Is it worth the... I think so. Right now, it's sold out, so... Yep, equip it to myself. Oh, something else good. I knew. Yeah. I don't really need any of those, really. I don't really mess with that either. I don't want to buy a song right now. Okay, here we go. I didn't fill that up. Oh, don't. I'm not weak, though. I'll make sure I have anything I can make stronger or.
Sunset for you.
Holy crap, I can really get this one upgraded nicely. That's about it though. Okay. Heck yeah, bro. Give me that. Yeah. There we are. Quite a few of my weapons and stuff. Make sure I got the best of everything though. Do those hunts and then continue the story.
If it's knowledge you seek.
Actually, I have to go do the hunts, but might as well do those.
Give me a second, I'm gonna look for the first one. See where to find it. Locate it first. There's both eyes right there. Tap travel. So the travel one, okay. Travel. So that's where I'll go to first. That's where she wanted me to go. Joel. Then, dig things right there. Hopefully this is the map. Yep, that is the map right there. Okay.
it's about right there. So I'm gonna put a little nugget right there. Jump onto my chocobo. I guess I'm gonna have to travel all the way over there, so it's kind of just close. I know where I need to go, so. Red Comet. Okay. Hopefully it's not too difficult. It is an A, so he's very powerful, so I've got to be careful of that.
Let's
tough one. What's a comet feather? That was a crafting item. Okay. Well, that one's done. Let's look for the other one. Go to the top somewhere, huh? Let's see. That building there, so it should be this one. Last, there it is. Last wing. Okay. Next, we got to see which map it is. That's a wide or I need to. It's closer down. Okay. So now. I know that's where I need to go. Wait, I think I need to go here, actually. Yep, so I need to find a way in by going ahead and touching that. Alright, here we go. There's a little trail somewhere that I need to get into. Gotta get up. I gotta climb up. Possibly. No? Okay. Gotta go around and up. Okay. How the heck do I do that? I see it over there. That's where I need to be going anyway, so I do need to get over there somewhere. How the heck do I get over there? Maybe this way? Is up there though. There should be a way to get up there somehow. Yeah, there has to be a way to get up there. Somehow. climb up. Oh, here we go. Alright, there we go. I think I got on the spot now. Alright, yeah. Okay, so I need to go all the way out here. Oh, maybe because it's in the cellar. Dang it. I think there is a cellar exit, actually. Little cellar, one of these buildings, maybe the main building up ahead. It's like the central piece in here. I remember it being in a building somewhere, going down into a cellar somewhere. I feel like maybe I need to go this direction. I think I got the right idea now. Smoky in here. Oh, here we go. This looks much more like it. Yes, this is definitely the way to go. What's up, homie? The Holy Trumpeter. He shouldn't be too difficult. Could be a pretty crazy fight, I think.
Still,
That was a pretty tough fight for a B. Scarlet type. Did you right? You got whooped, bro. Got whooped. Just looking to see if there's anything else. That guy got smoked. Alright. Oh, I just traveled, fast travel over there. So go back here. Actually do some more story. To this guy. Tell this guy, make sure there's anything else I need to take from him. No available quests, okay? Sure, I get my tonics and stuff. Alright, let's see if everything I have is the best. The best. Rune blade. Blade is the most powerful thing right now. I'm still not as strong as mine. Is the best. Okay, I think I got everything I need. Just make sure my hunts are all done. Cool. All right. This guy. Oh, I forgot to get pushed back and get later. If you're in, where the hell is everyone else? Don't tell me. They're all right. But if the long
long story.
I like the sword. I don't know why, but I like the little inconsistencies on it. It makes it look more, I want to call it badass. That's what it looks like to me anyways. Pretty badass sword. That's been a really good one I had before too. Oh, looks like my quest is going this direction now. I think I gotta see Midge or whatever her name is.
Do you think Midge ship? This is
seems the best invention. That sounds perfect. So associate something with its first person. Without that, perhaps I don't like that.
For days. Please tell me it is all right.
Possibly. You wouldn't happen to know what Bid's first opus was.
Opus?
That girl has come down as a Benji. Unless you mean York history. She couldn't have been more than 11, 12 when she called the whole thing together.
I'm surprised as well.
Not least her dad. We should have seen how proud he was of the little scamp.
Was that bad or upset to tell me anything?
I think she didn't have hidden something inside it.
You surprised me. I saw the bloody treasures. Half the things in the old world get a long time coming.
What didn't it break?
I was coming in here to play on the PS4.
You can continue to play.
Huh?
You can continue to play.
What do you mean?
Huh?
I said I was coming in here to play on the PS4.
Yeah, I said that. That sounds like a good idea.
Oh.
Join me.
You know, like that blanket I brought in here?
Yeah.
It's such a good blanket. It's so thin, yet it keeps you warm.
Mm-hmm. I don't like it when it's hot, though.
Yeah.
Because then it makes me sweat.
Well, that blanket doesn't make me hot. Like, this blanket does, but that one doesn't.
This one?
Yeah, that one doesn't make me hot.
Yeah, it's a thinner one. I thought you were talking about the one you have on you right now.
No, this one's weird when it makes me hot. So currently, I'm cool.
What's happened?
Dead by day.
She's refused to stop even for a moment. I've tried to see to him in her stead, but she won't.
Does Matt play that game?
No. Nor does Carson.
She
person tried to download it, and then it was like just saying update for him, because I think he was lagging. He didn't say anything, so he just deleted the game.
Is that a free game?
Yeah. The thing I'm trying to get for it is $40 though.
The what?
The thing that I'm trying to get on it is $40. They actually brought it down by $10. It used to be
$50.
Oh. Yeah. Like, the prices were so absurd that people were like, no. So. And also, this game is like dying slowly because, so many other games like it are doing better. So the first Modern Warfare, like that they had on here, it was like they didn't transfer any of the stuff that you had on there to this. So people got really mad. But now they're transferring the stuff from Modern Warfare 2 to Modern Warfare 3, so you actually have all the stuff you bought.
The crystal's curse has almost finished its work. If I had the tears, I could ease his passing. But without them, we've nothing that will touch the agony of those last few hours.
How would tears help this man?
Not my tears. Tears of mercy.
Look, Elysia.
It's perfectly spelled, too.
Oh, that's cool.
Sure. There must be something. Sometimes an easy death is the greatest kindness we can offer. You do well to remember that, Rodrigo.
Carson's PS4 is so much quicker than this one.
Oh, yeah?
It's like a fast, like, hot
dance. He has a PS4?
Yeah, he has a PS4. Didn't know Carson has a PS4?
I didn't know if it was a PS4 or a PS3.
Thank you, I'm playing on a PS3. Oh, PS3 actually got an update. Yeah, like it legit got an update on it. And you know what makes me mad? They rebooted Call of Duty 2 servers. Like on a PS3, Call of Duty 2 servers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but you know what they did? They made it only for Xbox.
Oh yeah?
Only for Xbox. It makes me mad.
That's pretty messed up. Why would they do something like that?
It's like, Jamama! Wah, 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 wah.
That's a cool samurai outfit.
Six.
Are you not playing?
What?
Are you not playing?
No, I'm dead.
Oh.
And then teammate came and killed Nathan in the back.
Oh, that's messed up.
And then my other teammate was AFK. And then my other teammate was Carl A. So finally came upon the rush. shot at them. She didn't do anything else. Shot at them. She shot my banner eventually.
This doesn't look like a regular Call of Duty. Oh. Oh, okay. Makes sense then.
Make peace with the best. Swallow your pride and focus on the world and your task at hand. Keeping the curse breakers on the moment. But if you come on, then it's going to be a straight time. We need to do something about it.
Just like you said, Rachel. You know it's right. It's not like you're going alone.
Extremely. What is it?
Are you streaming?
Just a video game.
Can you hear my voice even though your mic isn't muted?
No.
Charmer ain't letting anyone through.
Why are the gates closed?
Chief's orders. No one's allowed in without his say-so. Not that I'd have let you in anyway. You look like trouble. I suggest you go home.
That's what I'm trying to do, you little prick. Ain't changed a bit, have you, Snotty?
No. It isn't. Blackthorn.
Long time no see, eh?
What the hell are you doing here?
Well, it was meant to be a surprise, but since you are so nicely... I'm here to see Zoltan, you fucking numbskull. Now let us through!
All right. Just... don't go starting anything with the Chief.
Yeah, I promise I won't throw the first punch. That good enough for you?
Go on, then.
Much obliged.
So this is Dravosht. Not much going on, is there?
It's a smithing town. When I was a lad, you'd have to shout to be heard over the sound of hammer on anvil. Clive, you're good with people. You speak to Zoltan.
Hey, you ain't backing out now, are you?
There's a river of bad blood between me and the Chief. But if someone can build me a bridge, then I'll cross it.
All right. I'll see what I can do.
I appreciate it. It'll be near the forge on the hill. It was our master's. He'd have inherited it when I left.
The forge on the hill.
Good luck. You'll be needing it.
If we can't fire the forges, how are we going to earn our keep?
Shut your hole.
I have some things for sale. Go safely now.
Isn't there anything we can do to help? It doesn't seem fair.
Never in all my long years have things been as bad as they are now. Without magic to feed the furnace...
sorry, but if none of you lot can smell ore anymore, we're gonna have to start looking for new.
That's my obituary written, then. The man who closed the doors on his great-grandfather's forge.
Should be enough to last us a few moons, at least.
Hotter, damn it! Those miserable flames wouldn't melt butter, let alone iron.
Pardon the intrusion. I'm looking for the chief.
That'd be me.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
I'll bet it is. Keep the gates closed, I tell him. Well done, Snotty. You're not welcome here. Get out. Before things turn nasty.
Blackthorn's here.
What did you say?
He's traveled a long way to see you.
Yes, has he?
He's waiting. Down by the gates.
Then I suggest you take him with you when you leave.
Didn't you apprentice together?
So what if we did? Fuck! We're getting nowhere! These bearers' flames are next to bloody useless!
We're never going to be able to fire up the forges unless we can find some new crystals.
I'm a busy man, as you can see, so do me a favor and piss off. Oh, and if you're struggling to find your way out, ask Blackthorn. That prick knows exactly where the exit is. He's not wanted here. And neither are you.
All right. I'm going.
Chief, you've got to do something. If this keeps up, we'll...
we'll be ruined.
Bollocks. So bearer's magic's no more use than crystals.
It's no use. The flames just aren't hot enough.
Do it at once.
I suppose we could try working.
Mama? Why hasn't Papa...
But if we can't fire the forges, how are we going to earn our keep?
Let me guess. Zoltan told you to piss off.
As a personal favor to him, yes.
Well, at least he didn't beat about the bush.
There'll be no talking him round. Not after what I did.
Which is what exactly? If we're to help, we need to know. What turned the village against you?
I left. Dravosht. Zoltan. The burden of leadership our dying master dropped in our laps. All of it. There are two kinds of smiths in this world, you see. My kind, who are in it for the love of the craft, who labor on a single piece from dawn to dusk to get it just right. And the other kind, who are in it for different reasons. People like Zoltan, whose work is quick and cheap. The kind of smiths who shit out a few hundred blades, reap the profit, and divvy it out among themselves. There wasn't a single day we weren't at each other's throats. And bit by bit, people started taking sides. You would have torn Dravosht in half had it gone on. So, I left.
You didn't have to do that.
Zoltan's a better chief than I would have been. His way of doing things kept food on people's tables. Dravosht prospered without me and my lofty ideals getting in the road. Until the crystals run out at any rate. Without magic to fire the furnaces, this place is as good as dead.
It depends on how you look at it, though. There's got to be other ways of making fire. We manage it in the Deadlands.
Thanks to Sid's ingenuity, yeah. He saw all of this coming. New crystals were the problem, not the solution. And spent years coming up with ways of doing without.
You know what I mean, though, right? Where there's a will, there's a way. What I'm trying to say is that it's not your fault. You couldn't have predicted...
I don't want to be the great...
Good girl.
Fly, Ambrosia.
This won't be easy. Let's make this quick, shall we? Straight home now. No holding back.
Thank you.
flow.
I dare say that will be enough for a decent set of bellows.
What's this all about, then?
Don't know.
Any trouble finding the skin?
Nothing I couldn't handle.
There should be plenty. Right then, time to put these louts to work. If everyone pulls their weight, we'll be finished in no time.
Be damned! I honestly didn't think it'd work! But it's hot enough, all right, and without a single crystal in sight.
You know what this means, don't you?
I do, yeah! Dravosht is saved!
Sorry about earlier.
I take back everything I said.
Rodrigo could have mentioned his spiders would be the size of curls. Nice try.
Alright guys, I'm going to a hunt to fight this Mulboro thing, so wish me luck. I haven't fought a Mulboro since the first one that I played in the very beginning of the game. That I can remember anyways. I don't think I've fought any more Mulboros after that. This one's definitely going to be a lot more difficult to defeat though, so... That's where I'm located. We're almost there. Direction. Wish this chocobo would do a tighter turn, honestly. Yep, there it is. Mr. Carrot. Looks nasty. Thank you. That's a little intense. Alright. Let's go back to all these other hunts and stuff. I'm about to get off in a little bit. Complete these last little things and just continue forward. Well, the green pluses are like gear and stuff we can get from the game. I think I got my Ragnarok weapon from them. I don't want to talk about that. Completed that quest, thankfully. Looks like I'm about to level up again pretty soon. I don't want to hear anymore. Mindless talking to each other is ridiculous. Story, I'm good with, but this extra stuff is just aggravating. Keep messing up, sorry. Alright, so do one more little quest in the story and see where we can get to through to that.
They come.
was easy enough.
All right, you lousy lot. Get your asses on board. She's ready to sail.
You heard the captain.
Clive?
But I thought he was...
Confounded. Then it is as I feared. Sleipnir is no man, but a creation of Odin.
Phoenix's fiery fundament. Have you no normal enemies?
Up for another round?
Of course we are. Right, Lord Rosfield?
My boy, there was a time people called me the Executioner.
Or was it my eyes?
No matter, heads will roll all the same.
Mate, new plan! You leave, we follow!
Follow? Swimming, are you? Oh, bugger me! Weigh anchor! Engine's dead slow ahead!
Have care, my friends. It is not blood that runs through an engine's veins. These foes will not fall easily.
But they will fall.
Like oaks before a woodman's axe. Good thing I brought one!
How long are we meant to keep this up?
As long as it takes. Unless you have a better one.
Well, I've already killed at least 5 of the bastards.
Fuck it. Let's do the lot.
What do you want?
That's quite a mess you've made. And wholly unnecessary. You are my offering to Muthos. I would not see you damaged.
Now back to your stations! Every bell spent treading water puts another leak between us and the galleon.
I don't suppose Mid has a spare engine. Since you rose from the grave, my fortunes have plummeted. Are you absolutely certain of this quest of yours, Clive? The foes you face are as terrible as they are numerous.
Aye, and they'd have us live and die on their terms, which should answer your question.
You have that same stubborn look as your father did when he set his mind to something. On the battlefield, I am but a single axe. A deadly one, mind, but a single one nonetheless. Yet what you require is 1,000, and I believe my old friend in Brandalar can provide them. Take care, Clive. I have many more tales of your father's exploits to share. And I cannot very well do that if you're dead. Again.
Good luck, Uncle. And may fair winds attend you.
As for you, Joshua, take care.
I shall do my best, Uncle.
Farewell, my nephews. When next you see me, it shall be with an army at my back. Cheerio! Oh, yeah. Do keep up, my boy!
Well, we can't have him showing us up now, can we?
We would never hear the end of it. What have I done?
My lord.
between here and Walud. But any ship heading north has to round Zemeckis and put through the Narrow. Maintain our current bearing north-northeast, and we'll catch the Black Galleon before she vanishes again.
What's to prevent her from circling around Ash from the south?
With these winds in those waters, it'd take them forever and a fortnight to reach Stonehere.
Mid knows what she's talking about, Clive. Better than any of us lot, anyway. I say we do as she tells.
Sails on the horizon.
She's ours. Look alive, boys! Pull ahead! And keep those furnaces fed!
Aye, aye!
Do you feel that,
Jill?
All hands! Battle stations! Let's see what this girl can do.
Alright guys, so I thought I was gonna stop after that last one, but you know, I decided to continue. It's a little bit more story to it. I want to at least get to 2 hours and 30 minutes at least on this playthrough for y'all. I know I killed some hunts and did some side quests, got me some new gear and stuff. It was really nice. So if y'all go through my series, my episodes of Final Fantasy 16, you'll realize that I've lost the fight with Bahamut, and I lost that whole playthrough, unfortunately. But everything else you've watched so far, that's the Odin guy. But yeah, we're just gonna do a little bit more story. Story's what I really like. I just do the side quests because they're really good for continuing the story and getting stronger. So that's why you'd want to do the side quests. That and you're more of a completist. There goes Odin. She's even in there. So yeah, we get to fight a little bit more, that's good. Just the little guys though.
Thank you.
close to that. Alright, so let's see where I can find Jill. Just looking for boxes and stuff throughout. Just make sure I get everything in this game that I can. Before I go in the door, though, I just want to look around, make sure I'm not missing anything important.
Thank you. To where?
Thank you.
you coil your feeble souls is grown thick with desperation. And thus has my master turned to my blade. The world will soon be painted in black. And all that live shall gather in death's autumn wake. What if we remove the cause of this misery? What if we destroy the last of our mother crystals and restore balance to the world? Come on. Do you truly think it's so simple? A blight is inevitable. Not even the Almighty might stop its endless march. Your efforts will avail us naught. Not that is, but suffering. You must embrace the truth, Mythos. Accept your place with the Lord. Keep it. As long as there's a chance, there's a choice. Never led astray by your blind resolve.
Now, it is time you learn the inevitability of your divine fate.
How am I to be heard?
Get as far away as you can.
Clive, no.
Trust me.
Since I'll go to the
from your purpose.
And what is my purpose?
Mythos. Who are we? What are the dominants? The breath of the creator still warms.
We carry his life and we might guide the masters in his name.
We are the mighty acts of God.
We are more than that.
You would be nothing without what he has granted you.
The power we wield is his, and yet every time we draw upon it, it wears away at our very being.
It breaks us, it unlinks us, that its immaculate aspect might reveal itself. The icon. It is too much for me, his chosen few. Apart from you, Mythos, you wield the might of many,
yet your body does not answer for its avarice.
What are you saying? What I am saying is that your dominance are a means to an end. We were created for you. That you might drink deep of our strength and thereby fulfill your divine purpose,
which is to feed, as you would know,
could your work be on the walls of your prison of self-regard. As long as you choose to ignore this, you shall never penetrate my defenses. Still, you may take solace in the fact that you are not alone in your plight. The chains of omission shackle all of mankind, but there is yet cause to rejoice. For the Lord, in his mercy, has taken pity on his flawed creations, and shall see them restored to their proper forms.
What exactly would that
be? Why loyal servants to God?
They are men like you and me. Albeit ones unburdened by the wills that drive our kind to madness. They are pure. They are divine.
You mean to turn her against you? Not her, Mythos. Turn back.
For too long has mankind been led astray by their clamorous wills.
It is time to return to a world of quiet equality, where they might once more know salvation.
Salvation! And have you done everything we all did?
We don't need your salvation.
We'll save ourselves, and we'll do it in our own time. Not yours, and not your God. With every defiant expression of your will,
the tighter chains of consciousness become. But perhaps that fact may be put to use.
I'm not back!
What about us? Do we pursue him?
No.
No.
Our power to us against him enough. Whether we like it or not. Besides, there is something we must do first.
Of course. Drake's spine.
The idea is at the bottom of the sea. We'll lose one dam before the storm will over. But they know we're coming home. We'll need a plan. And a dam to honor that.
Then let's go home and find one.
Well, that was a magical experience. Alright guys, so that being said, this is where I'm gonna stop for tonight. So hope you all enjoyed the experience with me. That was very cool, very fun, very good little ending for my playthrough today. Alright, so with that I'm gonna say goodbye and thank you for watching Final Fantasy 16 with me. Until next time guys, I'll see you later. Bye.